Oh, hey Aruba.
Hey Scott.
How's it going?
Pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing good. I really love floating around in outer space.
Me too. It's pretty awesome.
I know. You know what else is awesome?
What else is awesome, Scott?
My magical fingers.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah, watch this.
Whoa, I'm Mr. Internet.
I know. Isn't that so cool? I wonder if you have magic fingers too.
I don't know. Let's see.
Whoa, hey Miss Beanstra.
Hey, Scott, what's that music?
Oh, it's my new favorite song. It's We Didn't Start the Fire by Billy Joel.
I really like it.
Yeah, it's really cool. I think we should just analyze its historical importance.
Let's do it!
Alright, sweet.
That's when Korea was split into North and South after World War II.
Yeah, and Korea is still divided along the 38th parallel. Rosenberg's H-bomb, Sugar Ray, Panmunjom, Randall, the King and I, and the catcher in the rye. Eisenhower vaccine, England's got a new queen. Marciano, Liberace, Santayana, goodbye. We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. We didn't start the fire. No, we didn't.
So Stalin was the dictator of the Soviet Union?
Yeah, but he died that year on March 5th. And that's also the year Nobel Prize winner Albert Einstein passed away, right?
Yeah, he's the one who developed the theory of relativity. Sputnik?
Yeah, the first satellite that the Russians launched into space.
Mafia, hula hoops, Castro, it's a little no-go. You do Simonry, Payola and Kennedy, Chubby Checker, Psycho, Belgians and the Congo.
When it says Castro, I think it means how he came into power in Cuba.
Yeah, when Cuba became communist. He also mentions John F. Kennedy becoming the 35th president of the United States, but Kennedy was later assassinated.
Hemingway, Eichmann, Stranger in a Strange Land.
Is that when we tried to overthrow Castro?
Yeah, but it didn't work thanks to Eisenhower's bad planning. On the bright side, John Glenn became the first American to orbit the Earth.
Big deal. I've been up there too. That was also the year JFK died.
Birth control, Ho Chi Minh, Richard Nixon, back again, moonshot, Woodstock, Watergate, punk rock, Bacon, Reagan, Palestine, terror on the airline, Ayatollahs in Iran, Russians in Afghanistan, Wheel of Fortune, Sally Ride.
So much information at once.
Yeah, but you can still understand. Like, when he says Reagan, he means how Ronald Reagan became our 40th president.
Yeah, so when he says Ayatollah, what does it mean?
That's when the Shah of Iran was overthrown and hostages were taken at the U.S. Embassy.
Okay, but I still don't get it. Why did Billy Joel even write this song in the first place?
Well, basically, the song was a rebuttal to the argument that his baby boomer generation was responsible for much of the world's problems.
Oh, so he's pretty much blaming other generations for the world's issues?
Not really. He just means that the world had been in the same troubled state since way before his time, and that it wasn't only them who had caused it.
Oh, I get it now. Well, this was really fun. We should do it more often.
Yeah, definitely. Come by next week, and I'll be analyzing the significance of Baby Got Back.
All right, it's a date.